Yeah, smith chart construction. Right. Yeah, so I'll be using this particular GeoGebra simulation to explain about smith chart. I told, right, so yesterday we have seen, so okay, okay, before that, good evening and welcome to yet another online tutorial on microwaves and antennas. Right, so we were discussing about smith chart. Right, in yesterday's class, we have seen construction of smith chart. So precisely, this is what we have seen yesterday, right? So we told smith chart consists of two sets of circles, right? Two sets of circles in complex gamma plane, right? So the first one, equation number 9, it is called constant resistance circle, constant R circle, right? And the equation number 10, it is actually what? Constant X reactant circle. So these are the two sets of equations which describe a smith chart, right? So smith chart, we are plotting it in complex gamma plane. So real axis, x axis will be gamma real and y axis will be gamma imaginary, right? And this entire thing, I told, it will happen within a unit circle, right? It will happen within a unit circle. Why? Because the range of value which gamma can take, right, modulus of gamma can take, is actually what, one, right? So we have two sets of circles. This constant R circles will be actually what, circles like this. So for R equal to 0, right, it will be centered at origin, right? Origin will be gamma R equal to 0 and gamma I equal to 0. That will be origin, right? When I say origin, this is actually what, gamma R equal to 0. This is gamma R equal to plus 1 and this is gamma R equal to minus 1. So this is gamma I equal to plus 1, this is gamma I equal to minus 1. So this entire thing, whatever smith chart, it happens within this, within the circle, right? So now constant R circles are circles like this. I'll just draw it here, right? There are circles like this. So excuse me, these are circles, but right, it looks like ellipse or whatever, right? So circles like this, and constant X circles are actually what, circles like this. It's not complete circles, part of circles, right? So it will be there on up and down. So this is actually what, these are nothing but smith chart. So we have to see what actually this smith chart. So this constant R circles are actually what, constant R circles, right, are a set of circles, right, the complete circle, set of complete circles with center at, right, constant R center at actually what, x1 y1 x1 is this and y1 is 0, right? x1 is this. So center at R by 1 plus R. So you can see center of this constant R circle lies along this real axis, right? And radius is equal to 1 by 1 plus R. So because of this, so when, if you substitute R equal to 0 in this, what will happen? If you substitute R equal to 0, if you substitute R equal to 0 here, what will happen? It will be, center will be at 0, 0. So that is the circle, right? And radius will be equal to 1. So for R equal to 0, you will get a unit circle. Right, and as R increases, what will happen? Radius will decrease and center will shift towards right, right, from here. We will see that, we'll try to see that. And similarly here, again, we'll try to see. So I'll just show the constant R and constant. So these are actually what? Constant resistance circles, right? Constant resistance circle for R equal to 0. So this is actually what, origin, right? Gamma R equal to 0, gamma I equal to 0, right? So R equal to 0 is the biggest circle, right? And it has center at origin and radius equal to 1. So R equal to 0.4 is actually what, slightly smaller circle, right? So now the center is shifted slightly to the right, right? But you can see all the circles are passing through this point, that is gamma R equal to 1 and gamma I equal to 0. All circles are passing through this common point, right? Gamma R equal to 0 and gamma I equal to gamma R equal to 1 and gamma I equal to 0. So this is constant R circles. You can see, as R increases, the radius decreases and this center move towards is actually what, positive x axis, right, or positive gamma axis. And for R equal to infinity, it will reduce to a single point here, right? Why? Because when R is equal to infinity, the center will be, right, radius will be actually what, 1 by infinity, that is actually 0. So it will reduce to a point, right? Similarly, constant x circles are like this, right? So for positive jx, right, it will be on the upper half, and negative gx, it will be actually what, for the lower half, right? If x is minus point is right. So if x is equal to zero, right? X is equal to zero. It is actually what? It will be a straight line. We'll try to see that. Right. X is equal to zero. It will be straight line. And for positive x, it will be actually what above this, right? So x is equal to 0.5. This is a circle. X is equal to 1. This is a circle. X equal to 2. Right. 3, 4, 5, 6. Right. So and similarly for x is equal to infinity, it will again become a point here. Right. And if you see this also, constant x circle also is actually what passing through the point gamma r equal to 1 and gamma I equal to 0. So this gamma r equal to 1, gamma I equal to 0, it is common points for both the circles. Right. You can see that. And this is our Smith chart, right? Very wonderful diagram. Right. Right. This is our Smith chart. So here you can see many. So I'll share a good resolution Smith chart with you. You can zoom it and see this one. I've taken from our textbook, right? So here it is written r equal to 0, right? R equal to 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, right? And r equal to 1, you can see it passes through origin, right? R equal to 1, this is r equal to 1 circle, right? It passes through origin, right? And as r increases, right, radius decreases and goes on. And similarly, x is right, x, if x is negative, right, it will be below this lower half of those curves will be in the lower half. If x is positive, it will be in the upper half. So we are going to see this as a simulation, right? So before that, right, just tell me the equations, right? Equation of constant r circle and constant x circles. So we once again, now itself we learned this, right? So constant r circles, constant r circle, the equation is, can anyone tell me that? Unmute and tell. I don't want to go back to that slide and write. Right. I hope all of you have taken it down. Or should I ask anyone? If I may ask, Ryan, can you please unmute and tell me what is the constant r circle equation? Ryan, please. So it is gamma r minus, is it r by 1 plus r? R by 1 plus r the whole square? Right. Gamma r.
Yes, sir.
Minus, yeah, yeah. So please tell me. Right. R by 1 plus r the whole square plus gamma I square is equal to 1 by 1 plus r the whole square. Right. So this is constant r circle. Right. So what will happen if r is equal to 0? If r equal to 0, the circle will reduce to actually what? Gamma r square plus gamma I square is equal to 1. So it will be a unit circle. Right, unit circle with center at origin, right, and radius equal to 1. And what will happen when r is equal to infinity? What will happen when r is equal to infinity? R is equal to infinity, which implies, so this is gamma r minus, so it is actually what? Infinity by infinity. If you differentiate this, right? So infinity by 1 plus infinity, or r divided by 1 plus r. So if you substitute r equal to infinity, it will be of the form infinity by infinity, right? So now what you do is you just use L'Hospital's rule. So if you differentiate numerator and denominator with respect to what? So d by dr of r by 1 plus r. It's not d by dr exactly, d by dr of numerator and d by dr of denominator, right? So I'll get 1 by 1. So I'll get 1. And so 1 by 2, right? 1 by 2, right? I'll get this 1 by 2. So if r is equal to infinity, it will be centered at actually what? Half comma, the point half comma 0. And radius will be equal to what? 0, which means it will actually what reduce to a point, right? It will reduce to a single point. So please, I didn't do it. Maybe you can try it out, right? So what will happen is it will reduce to a point, right? It will reduce to a point. So we'll try to see if it happens, right? So for that, I'll use this GeoGebra simulation, right? This is right. So this is my GeoGebra simulation. So I have written the equations here, right? this is equation for r, right? And so when r is equal to 0, I'll just zoom it in a bit, right? When r is equal to, I should zoom out a bit, I think. So when r is equal to 0, you can see the circle is centered at origin and its radius is equal to 1, right? Then if I increase r, can you see what happens? If I'm increasing r, you can see the circle is actually what? It's reducing its size, right? And if I further increase, right, as r tends to infinity, it will restrict to a single point at gamma r equal to 1 and gamma I equal to 0, right? So maybe we can see that simulation now, right? So what is happening, right? As r increases, you can see r changing, r increasing, right? Circles, right? So now I'll show you different circles. For r equal to 0, this will be the circle, right? And if r is equal to 0.2, this is the circle, right? R equal to 0.5, this is the circle, right? R equal to 1, you can see, right, it passes through 0, 0, right? And r equal to 2, r equal to, say, 5, r equal to 10. So these are one set of circle, constant r circles, right? So this, and I've taken only actually what certain values. I can take, if you take more closely spaced values, you will actually what get this Smith chart as what we have seen. So are you able to appreciate this? What happens to this constant r circle when r is changing, right? So what happens? It's radius will decrease and also center will move towards the positive gamma r axis. Initially the center will be at 0, 0, then it will move towards positive gamma r axis. Are you able to appreciate that from the simulation? Right. So that is one set of circle. Right. Next we have other set of circles. That is actually what constant x circle. So now before that, can anyone tell me what is the equation for constant x circle?
Gamma r minus 1 whole square plus gamma I minus 1 by x whole
gamma
square.
Gamma r minus 1 the whole square plus
gamma I
minus
1 by x whole
1 by x the whole square. This is equal to
1 by x whole square.
1 by x whole square. So which means its center is at actually what? Center is at 1 comma, say 1 by x, right? So this is x1 and this is y1. 1 comma 1. Center is 1 comma 1 by x, which means this is gamma r. Gamma r equal to 1 and gamma I equal to actually what? 1 by x. So gamma r is a constant. So gamma r equal to 1 means, right? So it's actually what? It's a straight line, right? Gamma r equal to 1, right? It's a straight line like this, right? So this center will lie along this and equal to 0, right? For x is equal to 0, what will be this equation?
Sorry to interrupt, sir. Your voice is breaking, sir.
For x is equal to 0.
Sir, could you repeat?
Center will be where is infinity. And Shervin, is it clear?
Now? Yes, sir.
Can anyone give me a feedback?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah, okay. So when x is equal to 0, what happens? It will be a straight line, right? When x is equal to 0, this will be a straight line. So a circle with infinite radius, it is nothing but a straight line, right? Which is passing through the real gamma axis, right? And when x is equal to infinity, what happens? Right, its center is at actually what? 1 comma 0. 1 comma 0 is actually what this point, right? And radius is 0. So it will shrink to this particular point. This is actually what x is equal to infinity. So, and in between, if x value is actually what positive, right? You will have for x is equal to 0.1, it will be something like this, right? X is equal to 0.2, 1, 2, 3, 4, like that, right? And similarly, this side also, right? It will be like this. So I'll show you the constant x circles right now in using simulation. So what you should keep in mind is if x is negative, it is actually what below this or in this lower half. X is positive, it is in the upper half, right? So if you have both these circles, that will give us the Smith chart, right? That will give us the Smith chart, right? So now what I'll do is, right, I'll retain these constant R circles there itself, right? Now with this, I'll introduce actually what x equal to, right, or else one second, right, equation 2, that is for x actually, right? So now I'm changing the value of x from, say, minus 10 to plus 10, right? In fact, it will change from minus infinity to plus infinity, right? If it is minus infinity, it will be a point at this point, right? It will be a point here, right? At this gamma r equal to 1. And plus infinity, again, it will be a point. So in between, so what happens, we'll see when x changes. Can you see what is happening when x is changing? All of you are able to see? When x is positive, right, it's on the upper half. Right now, x is decreasing. It became zero. At zero, you can see it was a straight line, right? And then negative, it is in the lower half. So are you able to appreciate this Smith chart thing? How it, right? So that is what actually is Smith chart. So maybe now what I'll do is I'll just write. So for x equal to minus 10, this will be the circle. X equal to, say, minus 5. Right, x equal to minus 2, x equal to minus 1, right, x equal to, say, minus 0.5, x equal to minus 0.2, right. I'll just, I've already typed in this, I'll share it with you, right, x equal to minus 0.01, it's almost actually what, it's close to that straight line, x equal to plus 0.01, it's above, right, x equal to 0.2, right, then 0.5. 1, 2, right. So this here come, right, are complete. So then x equal to 5 and x equal to actually what, plus 10, right. You don't have to consider the part of constant x circles outside the unit circle, that you can omit, right. Or we have to consider only actually what, the one within this unit circle, right. So that is our Smith chart. Once again, we'll go and see our Smith chart, right. So is it something similar? Are you able to relate it with what we have seen just now? Are you able to appreciate this? These are two sets of circle, constant R and constant X circles. The small r is actually what? Real part of normalized impedance, and small x is imaginary part of normalized impedance, right? And how this Smith chart works, suppose, right, a transmission line has characteristic impedance equal to, say, 100, and load impedance is equal to, say, 20 plus J 300, right? If load impedance is 20 plus J 300, then what will be the normalized load impedance? Z is equal to ZL by Z naught. That will be equal to, right, 0.2 plus J 3, right? 0.2 plus J 3. So that is R is equal to 0.2 and X is equal to plus 3. Right. So what you should do is you should identify which is R equal to 0.2 circle. So we will try to find out that in GeoGebra. Right. We'll try to find out that in GeoGebra. Right. R equal to 0.2 circle. Right. R equal to 0.2 circle is this. Right. This is R equal to 0.2. Not the first one, the second one. Right. This is R equal to 0.2 circle. Right. And one second. I'll just take. Right. So this one, right, this one is R equal to 0.2 circle. And can anyone help me find out which one is this X is equal to 3, right? Or suppose it was, say, 200, X is equal to 2, right? X equal to 2 is this, right?
Excuse me, sir. Excuse me, sir.
Right, yeah, I'm really sorry. Right, I lost connection in between. Right, it happens maybe due to this bad weather. Right, kindly excuse me. Am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, yeah. So, sorry, at which point, I lost connection at around when you send me message at that time?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So then we didn't miss much. Okay, fine. Yeah, I'll. Just go to this right. So yeah, so I was telling this entire circle circumference will be equal to lambda by 2, right? And this is short open circuit point and this is short circuit point. And if I'm traveling in anti-clockwise sense, right, along the transmission line, along the Smith chart, that is actually what movement towards. It corresponds to movement towards load, right? We made note of it yesterday, right? Movement towards load. And if you move towards actually what clockwise sense, it is actually what movement towards the source, right? So now what I'll do is now I'm going to plot a circle with center at origin and which is passing through the impedance point which I mark. Can all of you see a circle there? What I'll do is I'll just delete everything else, right? Right, everything else I delete now, right? So that it will be right. It won't create any trouble. Maybe a gamma equal to zero. That one I'll keep, right? Remaining everything I'll just simply remove for the time being, so that right, you won't have any confusion. I can just right, I'm removing everything. I'm just considering actually what only one point where r is equal to 0.2 and x is equal to actually what 2. Right, only that point I'm considering. Right, oh sorry, x is equal to 2. I should have retained x is equal to 2 is this. Right, so yeah, so you can see that intersects at actually what r equal to. So the point r equal to. Sorry, I should take pen. Right. R equal to 0.2 and x is equal to 2. That point is this, right? That is this point, right? Now what I have done is I have drawn a circle with center at origin and radius equal to what? This, right? Can you see the circle? This black color circle, all of you can see. That circle is called actually what? Constant standing wave ratio circle, right? Constant SWR circle, right? So initially, this is my load impedance ZL, right? This is my load impedance, and then what I did is I located the load impedance. How did I located the load impedance on Smith chart? Right. I'll repeat once again. Right. What we have done now is right. I'll just repeat once again what I have done now. Right. So given a transmission line, right? Given a transmission line of length L, right, with some load impedance ZL, right. So this is D equal 0 and this is D equal L. This is Z equal to 0 and Z equals L, right? So the characteristic impedance is actually what I told, it's 100 ohm and ZL is equal to say 20 plus J 200. Actual line impedance. So what we should do is when we are using, if I have to locate this ZL point on transmission line, first step is I should normalize it, right? I should normalize the impedance, right? I should normalize the impedance, right? Any impedance which is given, if I have to locate it on transmission line, I should normalize it. And how to normalize it? So normalized impedance Z is equal to actually what? Capital Z by Z naught. Here capital Z is actually what? ZL. So that is equal to 20 plus J 200, right, divided by 100. So that is equal to I can write 0.2 plus J2. So this is my R value now, small R value. This is my small X value, right? So now I should go and find out that. So small R value. Oh my God, sorry. Right, I'll just come back. Right. So I can plot it. So this is my complex gamma plane, right? So I know R equal to 0 is this, right? And r equal to 0.2 will be actually what? Some circle like this, right? R equal to 0.2 will be some circle like this, and j equal to 2 will be some circle like this, right? So the point of, I'll use some other color for x or y, right? Yeah, so x equal to 2 will be some circle like this. So this is the point. This point, you can see that is the point, right? 0.2 plus j 2, right? So now what I've done is that point we have located, then with center as origin and this much as radius, you want to draw a circle. So to solve problems on transmission line, what you should have is, you should have a compass, right? You should have a compass, and also you should have a Smith chart, right? So then what I have done is, I have drawn a circle, right? I have drawn a circle like this, right? So this circle is called, this green circle is called actually what? Constant SWR circle, right? Constant SWR circle, right? What is the significance of constant SWR circle? I'll tell just now, right? Suppose you want to see, so this is actually what? This is normalized load impedance, impedance at load end, right? Suppose you want to move towards the source end and find how impedance changes. If you want to know that, then what you should do is, you should move along this constant SWR circle in clockwise sense, right? If you move along the constant SWR circle in clockwise sense, it will tell you how impedance changes. And this, right, one complete circle corresponds to actually what? Distance of lambda by 2, right? Are you getting my point? Right, so what you should do is, you should locate a point and you should draw a circle with center at origin and radius is equal to this distance, right? So that is called constant SWR circle. And for a particular line, what happens when I move from load end to source end? If I want to know that, right, I should travel in clockwise sense. And if I travel in anti-clockwise sense, it's actually what? It corresponds to movement from source to load, right? So that's what I have shown here, right, in Smith chart here, right? So constant SWR circle is this, right? This is constant SWR circle. And you can see this constant SWR circle intersects the real axis at two points. One is this and the other one is this, right? So this, the point where it intersects the real axis on the right hand side, that will be corresponds to Z max, right? And this one will corresponds to Z min, right? If this is Z max, I told that will be numerically equal to rho, right? And Z min will be numerically equal to 1 by rho, right? Z min will be numerically equal to 1 by rho. So that is what we have to verify now. So this point, these two diametrically opposite point will be actually what? Reciprocals, right? Say this point and this point, they will be reciprocals. So I'll repeat once again. What we have done is, we have located the point, right, on Smith chart. So I'll take the original Smith chart now and show, right? So say this is this circle is r equal to 2, right? This circle is r equal to 2, and this is r equal to 0.2, and this is r x equal to 2, right? Point of intersection is this. So now what you should do is, you should draw a circle with center as origin and radius equal to this much distance. So you'll get a circle, right? That circle will intersect the real axis at two points, right? So the rightmost point will be, all of you can see this, I guess, rightmost point will be Z max, maximum value of normalized impedance, and leftmost point will be actually what? Z min. Rightmost point will be Z max and leftmost point will be Z min, right? So that is one thing. Now, rotation in movement in actually what? Clockwise sense, it corresponds to actually what? Movement towards the load end. Movement in anti-clockwise, it corresponds towards, corresponds actually what? Movement towards the source end, right? So that's what I just wanted to tell, right? Any doubt in this? Any doubt in this? I'll share a good resolution Smith chart with you, and also in note I have mentioned all these things in detail. You can read it out, right? But at this point, if you have any doubt, please feel free to ask. What I have done is, I just showed you how to locate a given point. If it is an XY graph, you know how to locate a point, how to locate a coordinate, 1, 2, how you locate in an XY graph. In an XY graph, you locate a coordinate. One second. Right. If it is an XY graph, right, if you have to locate a point 1, 2, right, what you will do is you will measure 1, right? So this is 1 and this will be 2, right? So this will be the point 1, 2, right? Or else a complex number with real part as 1 and imaginary part as 2. So similarly here, right, it is R plus JX. So R is R actually what R represents to some set of circles and X represents to actually what other set of circles. So for a given value of R and X, the impedance is given by what locating the those point of intersection of that value of R and that value of X. That's all I wanted to tell, right? That's all I wanted to tell, how to locate a point. So once you locate a point, what you should do is you should draw a circle with center as origin and radius equal to, right? If you call origin as O and this point as A, right, you should draw a circle with center as origin and OA as radius. So this is called actually what? Constant SWR circle, right? And it will intersect real axis on two places, right? So this point will correspond to what? Z max, and that will be numerically equal to standing wave ratio, and this point will correspond to Z min, that will numerically equal to 1/rho, right? So if ZL is given, right, if ZL and Z naught are given, if you are asked to find out standing wave ratio, how you will find out? That is a question, right? Normally, how we will find out standing wave ratio if ZL and Z naught are given, you will find gamma, right, as ZL minus Z naught divided by ZL plus Z naught, right? Then rho will be 1 plus mod of gamma divided by 1 minus mod of gamma. This is how you would have done, right? But instead of that, what you do is given ZL and Z naught, you find small z and mark it on the chart, right? Then you draw a circle with center as origin and OA as radius, then it will intersect the gamma R axis at two points, right? So, and the rightmost point, that is actually what maximum impedance, and that is equal to what rho. So if you can find out what is the value of gamma R at that point, right? If you can find out what is the value of gamma R at that point, that will be equal to the standing wave ratio, right? So you don't have to do analytic. That is what I told. Smith chart will ease out the problems. Smith chart will ease out the problems, right? So now, right, we have some characteristics of Smith chart, right? There are somewhere around 13, 14, 15 points, right? What I'll do is, I'll just, I'm not putting it down here, right? I'll just share it in Canvas. I want everyone to read that, and also please note it down in your notebook, right? So I'll read out some of the points, right? So the characteristics of Smith chart. So it was asked many times, right? Construction of Smith chart and characteristics of Smith chart, right? So maybe some of the points I can just jot it down here. Once again, right? So characteristics. Characteristics of Smith chart, right? So first point is constant R and constant X low K form two families of orthogonal circles, right? So constant R and constant X circles loci. So loci is nothing but what if you trace the movement of a point, right? That is called locus, right? So the constant R and constant X circles loci form two families of orthogonal circles. Like they'll intersect at right angles, right? They form two families of orthogonal circles. That is first point, right? So then that we have observed, right? So that we have observed already. Then second point which you have to note down is this constant R and constant X circles both, right, all pass through which point? I told all pass through, all will pass through the point through which point all circles are passing through. You can see here it passes through this point, right? The rightmost point. To this point, all circles are passing. That gamma r equal to, we have written it here, right? Gamma r equal to 1 and gamma I equal to 0, right? All the circles are passing through gamma r equal to 1 and gamma I equal to 0. So that is the next point, right? It passes through the point gamma r equal to 1 and gamma I equal to 0, right? Gamma r equal to 1 and gamma I equal to 0. Third point is, upper half of diagram, right? Third point is upper half of diagram represents actually what? Plus jx, right? Upper half of diagram represent plus jx, and the fourth point immediately follows that lower half of the diagram represents minus jx, right? So these are right what we observed now, right? These are what we have observed. So these are the characteristics, right? Upper half of diagram represents plus jx, lower half of diagram represents minus jx, right? And point number five, right? I'll just write it down now. Maybe we'll discuss it in detail later, right? So four, now we have seen impedance circles. I told initially itself we can either use it as impedance circle or admittance circle, right? So now I told you how to use it as an impedance circle. If you are using it as an admittance circle, what change we have to make, right? So that is what I'm going to tell, right? For admittance, right? For admittance, right? Constant R circle will become actually what? Constant G circles, right? And constant X circles will become constant B circles, right? Where G is actually what? The conductance, right? G is conductance, normalized conductance, and B is actually what? Reactance. So if you are using it as an admittance chart, right, these constant R circles will become actually what? Constant G circles, and constant X circles will become constant B circles. So impedance is actually what? R plus JX, and reactance is actually what? Y is equal to G plus JB, right? So only changes, constant R circles will become constant G circles, constant X circles will become constant B circles for admittance. And also open circuit and short circuit point will be interchanged, right? Open circuit and short circuit point will be interchanged. So while solving problem, we'll see it in detail. Now you don't bother about this use of it as constant admittance circle, right? So that is fifth point, right? So then sixth point, I already told the distance around Smith chart, right? Distance around Smith chart is lambda by 2, right? That is 1/2 wavelength, right? Distance around Smith chart is 1/2 wavelength, right? That is the sixth point. Sorry, 1/2 wavelength, right? So then the seventh point is, right? All of you are noting it down along with me. Please note it down along with me. Seventh point is, right? Right. We have seen which is, right, Z min and Z max, right? So I'll write at point of Z min, right? At point of Z min, right, that is equal to 1 by rho. At point of Z min, that is equal to 1 by rho, right? There is a V min on the line. There is a V min on the line, right? I'll elaborate this point, right? Suppose your requirement is to find the position of minima, right? Position of first minima from the load end. So for that, what you should do, right? You should just find out, right, from load end, how much you have to travel to reach Z min, right? So if you can find out that, that will give you the position of V min. So we, while solving problem, we'll try that. So now just take it down, right? Just take it down. While solving problem, it will be even more clear, right? at point of z mean 1 by rho there is actually v mean, and similarly 8 point is actually what counterpart of this at point of z max that is equal to rho there is a v max on the line, right? There is a v max on the line, that is the 8th point, right? At point z max equal to rho there is a v max of the line. So we'll solve a problem in tomorrow's class, we'll solve a problem to find position of v max and v min, right? That also can be done using a Smith chart, right? Right, then a ninth point is this again I'll write now, detailed explanation I'll give later, right? So the ninth point is the horizontal radius, the horizontal radius to the right of the chart, right? The horizontal radius to the right of the chart, right? Right of the chart center, right of the chart center correspond to horizontal radius to the right of the chart center corresponds to, I'll write V max, I mean Z max and rho. Right. So please note it down for the time being. Right. I've already discussed it, but in detail I'll tell later. Right. So then 10th point is, all of you are able to take it down along with me. 10th point is, right, same thing. The horizontal radius towards the towards the left of chart center. Horizontal radius towards the left of chart center. Right. It corresponds to actually what? V min, I max, Z min or 1 by rho, right? It corresponds to V min, I max, Z min and 1 by rho, right? And if you see Smith chart, there are, apart from the circles, there are two lines below, you can see, right? So these are nothing but what? The horizontal, right? Horizontal radius towards the right and horizontal radius towards the left, right? So this one corresponding to this and this, right? So these also we'll be using to find reflection coefficient, standing wave ratio, all those things. We may use this, right? We may use this. These scales we'll use, right? This is actually what the gamma R values, which is marked here, right? So, okay. Now please note it down. So the horizontal radius to the left of the chart center corresponds to V min, I max, Z min and 1 by rho, right? Then, right, then 11th point, very important point, right? Since the normalized admittance Y is reciprocal of the normalized impedance Z, right? So as Y is 1 by Z, right? Y is 1 by Z, right? As Y is 1 by Z, right? The corresponding quantities in the admittance chart are 180 degree out of phase with respect to those, right? So the corresponding quantities, right, whatever I have told before, quantities, right, please excuse the spelling mistake, quantities in admittance chart are 180 degree out of phase, right, are 180 degree out of phase with those in the impedance chart, right, with those in the right. Very important points, very important points. You should know all these points, then only you should be able to appreciate when we solve problems, right? So then 12th point is, The normalized impedance or admittance is repeated for every half wavelength of distance that we know, right? So this normalized impedance Z or Y repeats every lambda by 2 distance. We already know that, right? And if you see the Smith chart, right, there are some distance mark. You may not be able to see that now, right? If I zoom it in, right, you can see there are some distance marked here, right? You can see there are some distance marked here, right? So tomorrow I'll just use a better clarity, right? So these distance marked, right, what are those distance marked? That is the next point and the last point, right? The 13th point, right? The distance are given in wavelength, right? The distance are given in wavelength towards the generator and also towards the load, right? Towards number of wavelength towards the generator and towards load. So if you see the Smith chart, right, you can see if you travel in clockwise, if it is clockwise, travel in clockwise means it is towards the generator. Clockwise is towards generator and anti-clockwise is actually what? Towards the load, right? Clockwise is towards the generator and anti-clockwise is towards the load. So you can write that as well, right? So you can write clockwise is towards generator and anti-clockwise is towards load, right? So these are some of the 13 important points, right, about these Smith charts. Okay, all these are actually what from those two equations, and if you are able to visualize what is constant R and constant X circles, you will be able to appreciate. Right, that's it. Right. Any questions? Any questions? Right. So it's not a very straightforward topic. Right. What we have done is we have plotted two sets of circles, constant R and constant X circles. Right. Then we saw how to identify an impedance point, normalized impedance point in the chart. Right. And what is constant SWR circle? Right. And what is Z max, Z min? And Z max will be equal to rho, Z min will be equal to 1 by rho, right? And if you take any two diametrically opposite point in the Smith chart, right, they will be actually what? Reciprocals, right? So any doubts so far? All of you were able to take down what the 13 points I told? All of you were able to take down? Right, and how is the subject now? How do you find this topic? I need someone to give an answer, right? Maybe I'll ask Savan. So he's ready to answer. That's why, Savan, can you please unmute?
Yes, sir.
According to you, how do you find this topic, Smith chart?
It's okay, sir. But due to some network issues, I couldn't listen in the last moment. After 4:30, till 4:30, I'll listen. And
after 4:30 only main things came, I think. Right. Anyone who were there online throughout, if I may ask, Sharanya,
yes, sir.
Yeah. Did you understand the topics which we discussed today?
Yeah, sir. Somewhat.
Yeah, somewhat. So now, today itself, you should go and read it. Please, right. Otherwise, it's going to be actually what? A little bit difficult. Right. So, okay. any other... What about Shervin? Shervin used to give... correct... opinions, right? He will not actually what manipulate whatever he felt. Same thing. Is it Shervin? Now I would like to know your opinion. Yeah, the topic.
The subject.
So not the, today's topic.
Actually, it is good, sir. Like
we need a lot of practice. Actually, the basic, you need to remember, like, you need to relate so many things. So
at yes, the same yes, point. Yes. At the same, then only you will be able to completely appreciate. For that, you need practice, right? That is one thing I want to tell everyone, right? So please do practice. It's not simply reading, right? Try to get some hands-on experience. Try to draw it, right? Try to write down the equations. Try to simulate it, right? So I was just wondering, if the simulation was not there, what I would have done, right? Was the simulation helpful in visualizing this, Shervin? Constant R and constant X circles. Whether the simulation was helpful in visualizing this constant R and constant X circles.
Those equations. Yeah. Yes, sir.
Right. Okay. So before the simulations and all were there, we used to actually draw that on board, right? But now, as simulation is there, I can show it as some animation, right? Graphic. Like that, yeah. So that's it. If you have any doubt, please feel free to ask, right? And anyone else would? Shifani, can you please unmute Shifani? Shifani left the meeting as soon as I called out her name, right? Okay, Sauharth,
yes, sir.
Shifani is there, okay, yeah. How did you find this topic? And
sir.
Okay, and if you practice it, it would be okay, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Yeah, so I'll share the simulation with you. You can try out with that as well. But I don't know up to what extent you will be. Why? Because I have written some 40, 50, 60, 70 equations in that GeoGebra. Right. Maybe with a video, I'll just post that simulation alone, how you can use that. Right. I'll post it. Right. That's it. If you don't have any other questions, please type in your USN in chat window and you can leave. And those who have questions can stay back. Right. And thank you so much for a patient attention. Right. Even though it's a 4 to 5 slot. Right. And Shivaprasad, what about your short film? Are you really shooting a short film?
Yes, sir. Top, sir.
Yes, sir. We have seen his first look.
Is it? Okay.
Yes, sir.
With this brother, sir.
It is based on Money Heist?
Most probably, sir. He was.
Money Law.
Yeah. Sridhar was telling something. Yeah.
Based on Money Law, sir.
Okay. Survivo. Suvira, what was that? Survivo? Yeah, okay. Okay. Sean? Yeah, okay. Sorry, yeah. So, what we'll do is we'll wind up today's session. If you don't have any doubt, please feel free to leave the session. I'll just stop recording.